one of those moments where I just feel like I can make a difference in a couple of significant areas.
Bob Kerrey makes it official. The Democrat will run for one of Nebraska's seats in the U.S. Senate. His decision comes after months of speculation and controversy. We have live team coverage of today's developments. Good evening. I'm Rob McCartney.
And I'm Brandi Peterson. About an hour and a half ago, the former U.S. Senator officially filed papers to run for office again. The same office he said he would not seek just weeks ago. In our big story at 6, KETV News Watch 7's Todd Andrews is live with what changed Kerrey's mind and what he's saying about the race ahead.
The 68-year-old Kerrey says he's not taking anything for granted these days. He knows he has a long road ahead and acknowledges that his wife actually paved the way for him to run. Only KETV News Watch 7 is there as Bob Kerrey walks into the downtown Hilton and greets supporters after having just decided to run for Senate.
I didn't make a final decision until today.
A choice that came, he says, at the urging of his wife, Sarah, who until recently was against the idea.
She said, it doesn't look to me like you're very happy. If it's going to make you happy, run. Her vote is bigger than anybody else's out there.
Kerrey admits his path to candidacy, which included an initial no 3 weeks ago, was unconventional. He also acknowledges he'll have to battle now for the hearts of voters who think he's out of touch with Nebraska.
But I'll start off behind, and I say the odds don't necessarily favor me being victorious in November.
But Kerrey, who served as U.S. Senator from 1989 to 2001, believes his experience in Washington will shine through. He declined to be specific, though, when asked about reports he'd already talked with Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid on getting his old seniority back if elected.
I am going to be in a position to do some real good for Nebraska, as well as have an impact on some significant national problems.
And as for his reaction to claims that he'd waited until after the incumbent filing deadline to decide on running to ensure Governor Dave Heineman was not running.
I'm not that smart. I certainly didn't time it that way.
We also asked Kerrey what his message was to fellow candidate Chuck Hazebrook, who decided to run only after Kerrey told him earlier this month that he would not run.
I feel very badly about that because Chuck was relying on my earlier decision. I know this has put him in a very, very difficult position.
Kerrey says he's spoken to Hasbrook today and that they'll talk more about the situation. Now, as for residency requirements pertaining to his run for Senate, Kerrey tells me he already has temporary living arrangements in Omaha in place and his family will look for something more permanent in the near future. Brandi, Rob.
Thanks, Todd. And Chuck Hasbrook says he is still in the race.
And even though he says Kerrey broke his word, Hasbrook says he's not holding any grudges, just focusing on an aggressive primary campaign.
Here's KETV News Watch 7's Natalie Glucklich.
I'm here in Lyons, Nebraska, Hassebrook's hometown, where he tells me he's, quote, disappointed that Bob Kerrey broke his word and decided to run. Hassebrook tells me that he ran on the pretense that Kerrey would not. Kerrey even went so far as to endorse him. Hassebrook has left his job. He says even though he knows he's the underdog, he still feels like he has a good chance.
Everything I've done in life that matters, I've done as an underdog. The first time I ran for Board of Regents, nobody gave me much of a chance. I was outspent 2-1, and I won that. I mean, I'm disappointed that he broke his word on that. But any Nebraskan has a right to run for office, now I go to work putting together a competitive campaign for the primary.
Hassebrook says he and Kerrey have emailed today, but he wouldn't disclose what was in those emails. He also says that now he is gearing up for a primary campaign different than it would have been. He says he's going to have to be a lot more competitive. Reporting in Lyons, Nebraska, Natalie Glucklich, KETV News Watch 7.
From those who know Senator Kerrey to voters just hearing the news this afternoon, there are plenty of opinions about today's announcement. KETV News Watch 7's Jeremy Maskell continues our Big Story team coverage.
And Brandi, some of the voters we talked with today have never really heard much about Bob Kerrey. They weren't paying attention to politics before Kerrey left office in 2001. But many Democrats hope his experience brings excitement to the race, excitement and their best shot at keeping Senator Nelson's seat.
Talk with someone like Omaha City Councilman Ben Gray and hear hope for one exciting Senate race.
I think it's good news because I think it's going to make the race a lot more exciting. I think it's going to be a lot more challenging.
Gray says Kerrey's announcement may mean a more meaningful debate about issues important to Nebraska, but talk with voters and hear Kerrey's challenges.
But the fact that he's been gone and out of the state for quite some time may pose some challenges to his campaign.
He's got a life back east. Go back east and stay there.
GOP attacks already seem somewhat successful at painting Kerrey as a former Nebraskan.
I think he's going to have a real uphill battle. And I think a lot of Nebraskans are just fed up with that type of politics in general.
But Democratic supporter Anthony Marsh says Kerrey fills a void in this race in Nebraska politics as a whole.
There's a real power vacuum. There really aren't a lot of good Democratic politicians at this point.
All agree, though, it's possible Kerrey could win.
Absolutely.
In a race now reaching a higher profile.
Not one voter I talked with today said Kerrey's decision to run after saying he would not made much difference to them. The biggest challenge we heard, as you just did, was Kerrey's time away from the state of Nebraska. Brandy?
Jeremy Masco reporting live tonight. Thanks, Jeremy. Now, Kerrey's motivation for running sounds strikingly similar to what he said 25 years ago. In 1987, the former governor had said he would not run for U.S. Senate. But when former Nebraska Senator Edward Zirinsky died, Kerrey said a friend talked him into reconsidering.
You simply can't be so selfish that you don't try to serve us some more.
Kerrey won the 1988 election and won re-election to the U.S. Senate in 1994. In 92, he ran for president, but dropped out of the race in the spring after several primary defeats. You can let us know what you think of Kerrey's decision on our website. Plus, see what others in the area are saying. We've also linked to our previous stories on Bob Kerrey. Just go to KETV.com.